Hi everybody, my name is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com. This is tutorial 1.4, select a background image, header type, and theme using the Google Sites training framework. So what you'll notice here that's different from the last tutorial is I've actually removed my image here because I wanted it to be blank so I can show you how to change the image and how we can change this background image right now. So what we're going to do, when you get to your Google site, you're going to hover over this, you'll click change an image. You can either upload an image or select an image. When we select an image, we actually have a lot of options here. So we can actually pull from the Google Site Gallery. We can pull an image from the internet by using the URL. We can search for an image, that's what we're going to do. We can pull an image from our albums that are connected with Google Drive, or we can pull an image that's been saved in our Google Drive. So let's click on search. And I'm going to type in classic books. And this is going to be the background, right, of the Google Site tutorial page that we're doing here. And so let's just find one. I'm just going to grab this one right up here. I like this one. We're going to click on select. And what you'll see is now our background image has this image that we just found. This is how you would select your background image on your homepage for your Google site. The next step that we're going to do is we're going to change our header type. And you'll notice as I hover over this section here, I have a couple different options. I can reset this and it'll go back to a blank background that was just black, and I can change my header type. Well, when I click on header type, I'm gonna have a couple of different options. I can have a cover, which is a little bit larger. I can have a large banner, which is what we were looking at just a few seconds ago. I can have a smaller banner, or I can just have the title only. That removes my image from the Google site. So you want to choose one of these options, a large banner, a banner, or a cover. For me personally, and my background and business and doing websites and different things like that, I like a small banner so people can see the content when they come to the homepage, that the banner does not cover up the entire screen. This is not a photo album. This is something that we want people to come and watch the tutorials and go through this process. So that's how we would select our header type. Now, with Google Sites, every site has some pre-built themes. And a theme is a color palette and a font palette or a font selection that is connected with that theme. So the way that we change our theme is we come over here, the top right, we click on themes. And as I scroll up and down, I'm going to show you how these themes change as I scroll through them. So you're going to see a color palette change and you're also going to see a font change. So when I click on simple, you'll notice that the colors are a little bit darker and the font is a little bit thinner. For any theme and any font and color, you have the option to change it however you want. You'll notice here, if I go for a dark theme, right, that doesn't really mesh very well as far as my image in the background and the color here, but if I could find a color that was in here, maybe like this green that I like, or I can go to the bucket and I can pull off the letter code for each number. I can't remember the technical term for that right now. And I can select this however we want it to do. And you'll see, so I could start to match this up really quickly. So I'm trying to get it close to this color here, like a maroon or burgundy. And so you can spend hours and hours and hours doing this. And this is where a lot of people get stuck, is not on the information that's on the Google site, but on what it looks like, because it's so much fun to move around. So as we go down to the next temp theme, you'll see again that the text and the color palette changes. When I click on font style, I have the option to change to a few of those different font styles. Now, I'm not going to click on all of them and go through all of the color palettes because hopefully you're doing this along with me. I'm going to go back to our original yellow green and maybe I'll just change the font to capitals. I think maybe that's what it already is. Let's do Frank, right? I like the typewriters and that font. In our next video, 1.5, we'll be talking about adding, reordering, and nesting pages. This has been a tutorial on 1.4, which is selecting a background image, header type, and theme. Again, my name is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com. I love you, I appreciate you, and I am glad that you're here.